Okay, everybody, assalamu alaikum. The topic for today's class is complete paper of basically October, November 2020, and this is variant 1. And this is full exam paper, paper 1. And I will try to complete this paper as early as possible so that you can see it very quickly. And now coming to the questions, what questions are being asked. So, आपको जो लोग अक्टूबर नवंबर में अभी एग्ज़ाम देना चाह रहे हैं उनके लिए बहुत अच्छी अपॉर्चुनिटी होगी कि उनको एक फुल फ्लेज एग्ज़ाम पेपर मिल जाएगा. दिस इज़ नॉट द ओनली पेपर आई एम बेसिकली अपलोडिंग, अदर आई विल बी अपलोडिंग अदर पेपर्स एज वेल. ठीक है, सो इफ़ यू आर गोइंग टू अपियर इन अक्टूबर नवंबर एग्जामिनेशन, देन यू मस्ट keep watching this video series. It will really really help you, inshallah. And furthermore, I also suggest you to try to get this book, AS Topical Paper 1 by Kamar Baloch, and it is easily available online as well as you can search it on bookstores as well. Question number 1 is, the diagram shows an economy's production possibility curve. It has been employing its resources in the ratio of 80% consumer goods production and 20% capital goods production. Okay, so what will be the result if it decides to double its output of capital goods? Acha, iske liye best tarika ye hai ki you must stop the video and read the question carefully first and try to figure out what is the answer of this question. Then again you can play the video and see what is the correct answer actually. So इस ग्राफ को अगर आप देखें, इफ़ द प्रोड्यूसर बेसिकली यूजेस ऑल ऑफ हिज रिसोर्सेज ऑन प्रोडक्शन ऑफ कंज्यूमर गुड्स, देन ही कैन प्रोड्यूस मैक्सिमम 1000 यूनिट्स ऑफ कंज्यूमर गुड्स. एंड इफ कंज्यूम प्रोड्यूसर यूजेस ऑल ऑफ रिसोर्सेज फॉर प्रोड्यूसिंग कैपिटल गुड्स, तो उसके पास मैक्सिमम जो आउटपुट है दैट इज़ 50 यूनिट्स, राइट? सो 100% रिसोर्सेज के साथ 50 यूनिट्स आउटपुट बना सकते हैं. अगर 100% यूनिट्स रिसोर्सेज के साथ कंज्यूमर गुड्स 1000 प्रोड्यूस हो सकती हैं, तो 80% रिसोर्सेज के साथ 800 प्रोड्यूस हो रही होंगी. देन व्हाट अबाउट 60% रिसोर्सेज? 60% रिसोर्सेज के साथ डेफिनेटली 600 प्रोड्यूस हो रही होंगी. और 20% रिसोर्सेज अगर आप कंज्यूमर गुड्स पे ऑलरेडी लगा रहे हैं और नाउ यू वांट टू डबल इट, इट मींस यू विल हैव टू विदड्रॉ 20% रिसोर्सेज फ्रॉम कंज्यूमर गुड्स टू मेक इट 40%. तो अब आप क्या करेंगे अगर 80% रिसोर्सेज के साथ आप ऑलरेडी 800 यूनिट्स बना रहे थे, तो 60% रिसोर्सेज आपके पास रह जाएंगे चूँकि 20% आपने इस पर एलोकेट कर दिए. सो 60% रिसोर्सेज के साथ आप 600 यूनिट्स बना सकेंगे. सो जब आपने ऐसा किया तो आपको अब 200 यूनिट्स कंज्यूमर गुड्स के सेक्रीफाइस करना पड़ेंगे. सो ऑप्शन सी इज़ द करेक्ट आंसर. आई बिलीव यू गॉट द आइडिया. इफ़ देयर इज़ कन्फ्यूजन यू मे राइट इन द कॉमेंट बॉक्स. ओके, आई विल ट्राई टू आंसर योर क्यूरीज. एंड नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, विच कॉमेंट रिलेटिंग टू इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ चार्जेस फॉर प्रीवियसली फ्री मेडिकल ट्रीटमेंट इज नॉर्मेटिव. ओके, सो नॉर्मेटिव स्टेटमेंट आर द स्टेटमेंट्स दैट आर बेस्ड ऑन वैल्यू जजमेंट और बेस्ड ऑन ओपिनियन. सो अनफेयरनेस, फेयरनेस एंड अनफेयरनेस, दीज आर द थिंग्स दैट कैन नॉट बी मैथमेटिकली एक्सप्रेस. दे आर बेसिकली बेस्ड ऑन ओपिनियन. सो समवन माइट बी थिंकिंग दैट इट इज़ फेयर, दैट समवन माइट बी थिंकिंग इट इज़ अनफेयर. सो बी इज़ द करेक्ट आंसर. सो इट इज़ नॉर्मेटिव स्टेटमेंट. देन कम्स क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, विच कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ मनी इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट if it is to function as a medium of exchange. Medium of exchange means you can use money to purchase goods and services, and when you want to purchase goods and services, then the money you are using must be generally accepted by everyone in the society. So acceptability is the feature that must be there to function money as a medium of exchange. अब देखें, आप मार्केट में बाय करने के लिए चीज़ जाते हैं, फ्रूट वेंडर के पास जाएंगे, कहीं फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन के पास जाएंगे, कहीं फर्नीचर वाले के पास जाते हैं, कहीं भी आप जाते हैं, तो आपको लाइक जो पैसा आप लेके जा रहे हैं दैट मस्ट बी जनरली एक्सेप्टेड बाय एवरीवन, तभी वो एक मीडियम ऑफ एक्सचेंज के तौर पे आपके पास काम कर रहा होगा. अदरवाइज़ वो ज़ाहिर है मीडियम ऑफ एक्सचेंज के तौर पे फंक्शन करना उसके लिए पॉसिबल नहीं होगा. Then comes question number 4. What is not characteristic of planned economy? Planned economy is under the government and you have to find out what is not in the planned economy. Okay, so we can see consumers have limited influence on what is produced. It happens in planned economy because consumers' choice is not available. They definitely have limited influence. Consumers are basically given preference in private economies, not in the government and planned economies. Profit is the motive for increasing output. It is not, because planned economy aim to increase social welfare instead of increasing profit. So this type of thing is not found in planned economy. So examiner is saying what is not found. So B is the correct answer. Okay, so we can move to the next question, that is question number 5. Good X is substitute of good Y and a complement to good Z. Substitutes are alternative products like Coke and Pepsi. Suppose this is Coke and this is Pepsi, for example. I'm just labeling it, making basically renaming it. X is Coke and Y is Pepsi, for example. And Z is complement. Complement mean the good that is jointly demanded. For example, it is sugar, right? What would happen if a fall in price of what would happen after a fall in the price of X? If price of X mean price of Coke falls, and what will happen? If price of Coke falls, it means more people will be now buying Coke, and demand for Pepsi will fall. Demand for Pepsi, because people think that Pepsi is now expensive relative to Coke, so they will purchase more Coke and they will purchase less Pepsi. So demand for Pepsi will fall. Mean demand for Y will fall. First of all, we can find out where demand for Y is falling. So it is happening in option C. So demand for Y will fall and for Z will rise. Since Z is complement to basically X good, so if Coke is cheaper, it means now more Coke will be demanded and producers will definitely produce more Coke, and when it happens, then they will need more sugar to add to their basically drink. So demand for sugar will rise. So now, as I basically renamed the scenarios, the basically names of products, so aapke liye C option hoga ki Y, demand for Y will fall, because Y, substitute of Y is relatively cheaper, now people will buy that more, and demand for Z, that is complement, will rise. So option C is correct answer. And now coming to question number 6. Question number 6 says, the table shows how an individual's weekly consumption of biscuits and coffee varies with the income. Okay, so these are basically values given here. Which statement about the income elasticity of demand over the range of income shown is true? Income elasticity of demand is basically calculated as YED is equal to percentage change in quantity demand over percentage change in income. So this is the formula. And you can see percentage change in income is percentage change in income. Kaise find karenge? Percentage change ke liye formula hota hai change divided by initial, that was 100 multiplied by 100. So this is 50%. So income is increasing by 50%. And biscuit demand for biscuits is increasing from 0 to 5. So it is a lot. So it means it can be around 500%. So what will happen is the answer will be greater than 1. If numerator is more than the denominator, then answer will be greater than 1. Okay, so although the value here will be infinite, mean infinite is definitely more than 50%. So answer will be greater than 1. For biscuits, it is greater than 1. This is the correct answer. For biscuits, it is 0. It is not 0, because demand for biscuits is increasing. It is not constant. Agar ye 0 hoti, to phir yahan pe 0 aa jata aur answer bhi 0 ho jana tha. But demand for biscuits is increasing. It is not 0. It is not constant. Aur for coffee, it is less than 1. Less than 1 to nahi hogi, kyunki quantity demand for coffee, agar aap dekhe, to 100% badh rahi hai. ठीक है, चेंज इन डिमांड फॉर कॉफ़ी फाइंड करने के लिए, परसेंटेज चेंज इन डिमांड फॉर कॉफ़ी के लिए आप क्या कर रहे होंगे कि चेंज इन क्वांटिटी डिमांड ओवर over Q1 mean initial quantity into 100. This is a formula for this. अब आप देख सकते हैं कि change in quantity is 5. So 5 over 5 that was initial multiply by 100. So 5 से cancel हो जाएगा, 100% आ जाएगा. So 100% over 50% that is percentage change in income is equal to 2. तो ये this is not less than 1. So इसको हम cross कर देते हैं, इसको भी cross कर देते हैं. For coffee it is unitary, unitary भी नहीं है. Unit mean 1 but it is greater than 1. So 2 is answer here. So it is greater than 1, not unitary. तो इसलिए हम इसको भी choose नहीं करेंगे. Option A is correct answer finally. And now coming to question number 7. The diagram shows 4 supply curves. Which statement about the price elasticity of supply curves is correct? Okay, so W has elasticity of 0. W has elasticity of supply 0 that will rise as price rises. Okay, and then X has elasticity greater than 1. This is X. This is not greater than 1. Basically, when graph starts below origin point, this is inelastic or less than 1. And when it starts above origin point, that is greater than 1 or elastic. So Y has elasticity greater than 1 and it will fall with the price rise. So this is correct answer because on Y it is basically greater than 1 and it continuously keeps decreasing because the trend is more towards quantity instead of price. So option C is correct answer. Okay, so next question is question number 8. And the question number 8 says the diagram shows the market for a good with an initial equilibrium price $10. So this is the price. The demand for a good increases by 40 units at every price, causing equilibrium price to rise to $12. Now price rises to $12. Okay. What is the value of producer surplus? Okay. So producer surplus is basically producer surplus is the area above supply curve and below equilibrium price. So this is equilibrium price and this is the supply curve. So this will be the area of consumer surplus. And you can find this complete triangle is the consumer surplus. So consumer surplus is calculated as 1 over 2 since it is triangular area. So 1 over 2 into height into base. So 1 over 2 height is basically 12, 0 to 12 it is 12 multiply by base, you can find base here, this is 120 multiply by 120. Okay, so what you can do is now you can cancel out values, 2 1s are 2, 2 6 are 12, 6 multiply by 120 is 720. So $720 is the correct answer for this question. Now moving to question number 9. Question number 9 says the equation of for quantity demand QD is this, where price is price in dollars, the quantity supplied QS is given by this. Okay, so ye demand and supply ki aapko different usne equation form mein aapko de diye. What change will occur if the price rises from 5 to 6? Okay, so we can find out quantity demand. Suppose this is, you can make a table, this is price, this is quantity demand, and this is quantity supplied. Okay, so initially price was $5. So what you can do is simply put the value of price $5 here. So quantity demand will be 400 minus 20 into 5 will be 100. So it is 400 minus 100 is equal to 300. So quantity demand is initially 300. And now put the value 5 here as well to find out quantity supply. So quantity supply will be 100 plus 4 into 5 is equal to 5, 4s are 20, so this will be 200. So 300, it will be again 300. So supply is also 300. So initially we are in equilibrium. Equilibrium is a scenario when quantity demand is equal to quantity supplied. Now examiner says that price increases from 5 to 6. Now we will have to replace value of price. And now we can put value 6 here. So 400 minus 6, 2s are 12, so 120, and this will give us 280. So 280 is the quantity demand. So when price is 6, 280 is quantity demand. And now put the value 6 here as well. I can write it here, 100 plus 40 into 6. So 100 plus 40 into 6 is equal to 240. So 240 plus 100 is equal to 340. So quantity supply is 340. Now you can see that supply is more than demand. When supply is more than demand, we call it surplus, right? Okay, so now we can find out our correct option here. The market will move to equilibrium, from equilibrium to shortage. So it was in equilibrium initially because demand and supply were equal, but there is no shortage, this is surplus. Market will move from equilibrium to surplus. This is correct answer because initially we demand and supply both were same, that is 300 300, so we were in equilibrium, but now we are in surplus. So B is the correct answer. I believe you got the idea. Lekin agar aapko confusion ho to aap comment box mein likhe and I will try to explain you if there is any ambiguity. Okay, now coming to question number 10. A farmer divides his land between growing two crops, wheat and oats. Oat is basically another name for barley. And to increase production of one, he must reduce production of the other. Okay, so what would cause the farmer to increase his supply of wheat? Okay, so सप्लाई ऑफ वीट कब इंक्रीज करेगी, क्या चीज़ें जो कॉज करेगी? सो इसके लिए ऑप्शन डी करेक्ट आंसर है. देर इज इम्प्रूव्ड एफिशिएंसी इन हार्वेस्टिंग वीट. डेफिनेटली जब आपकी एफिशिएंसी बेटर होगी तो प्रोडक्शन भी आपकी इंक्रीज हो जाएगी. नाउ कमिंग टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 11, एंड क्वेश्चन नंबर 11 सेज व्हाट वुड कॉज द डिमांड कर्व फॉर वेजिटेबल्स टू शिफ्ट फ्रॉम D1 टू D2 एज शोन बिलो. सो इट इज़ मूविंग टू द राइट, मीन डिमांड इज इंक्रीजिंग. A change in supply from Q1 to Q2. Okay, a poor harvest due to unfavorable weather, a rise in a price change from P1 to P2, and rise in income. So D is correct answer. Demand is increasing. Income is a demand factor. When income increases, demand also increases. So D is correct answer. Question number 12 says the demand curve for new cars in a country shifted to the left. If demand curve shifts to the left, what change would have caused such a shift? Why demand curve may shift to the left? Increase in disposable income. If income increases, demand must have increased. So demand is decreasing. When demand shifts to the left, it means demand is decreasing. ओके, सो डिस्पोजेबल इनकम अगर इंक्रीज करी होती तो डिमांड को राइट वर्ड जाना चाहिए था, नॉट लेफ्ट वर्ड. उसके बाद इंक्रीज इन द कॉस्ट ऑफ बोरोइंग. कॉस्ट ऑफ बोरोइंग अगर इंक्रीज होगी तो इसकी वजह से ऐसा पॉसिबल है कि डिमांड मे शिफ्ट टू द लेफ्ट और नॉट. कॉस्ट ऑफ बोरोइंग इज बेसिकली द सप्लाई फैक्टर, राइट? एंड okay, so what will cause, which change would have caused such a shift? Okay, so an increase in cost of borrowing is the factor that can basically cause this, because when cost of borrowing mean getting loans from financial institution is expensive, people will get less loan, and as a result they will be able to purchase less quantity of goods and services, so demand will fall. Now coming to question number 13. What is correct about market supply? Market supply is basically the horizontal sum of individual supply curves. Firm A, firm B, firm D, जितनी भी firms होंगी उनकी जितनी भी supply होगी उनको अगर हम sum up कर लेंगे तो वो हमारे पास industry supply या market supply आ जाएगी. So option C is correct answer. Market supply is the result of aggregating the supply of all individual firms. For example, if there are 3 firms, then we can sum up the value of supply of all 3 firms, then we will get aggregate or total supply of the market or industry. Now question number 14, which statement best describes a transfer payment? Transfer payments are basically the payments which we make without taking any kind of good or service. Jaise for example jo pocket money hai wo bhi ek transfer payment hoti hai. Donations hain wo bhi transfer payments hain. Pensions hain wo bhi transfer payments hoti hain. आप ऐसी पेमेंट्स जिनके अगेंस्ट किसी किस्म के गुड या सर्विस आपके पास एक्सचेंज ना हुई हो, कोई एक्टिविटी जनरेट ना हुई हो। जी, ऑप्शन बी इज़ करेक्ट आंसर। इट इज़ अ पेमेंट टू इंडिविजुअल्स नॉट लिंक्ड टू इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी। लाइक जब भी आप इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी करेंगे, कोई चीज़ प्रोड्यूस करेंगे या फिर गुड प्रोड्यूस करेंगे, प्रोडक्ट प्रोड्यूस करेंगे, सर्विस प्रोड्यूस करेंगे, तो उसके अगेंस्ट जो पैसे आपको मिलेंगे वो आपकी अर्न्ड इनकम होती है, और जो उसके अलावा है वो आपकी अनअर्न्ड इनकम होती है। क्वेश्चन नंबर 15 इज द डायग्राम शोज द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ अ यूनिट टैक्स इम्पोज्ड बाय अ गवर्नमेंट ऑन अ गुड। द ओरिजिनल सप्लाई इज S1 एंड कर्व शिफ्ट आफ्टर सप्लाई कर्व आफ्टर द यूनिट टैक्स इज S2। सो इफ गवर्नमेंट इम्पोजेज टैक्स देन सप्लाई डेफिनेटली शिफ्ट टू द लेफ्ट। ओके, सो इनिशियली इक्विलिब्रियम प्राइस वॉज दिस मच। सो इनिशियल इक्विलिब्रियम प्राइस वॉज 60 and now after the shift equilibrium price will move to 70. It means now consumers will be paying this much and this is the quantity. Now if we have to find out total amount of tax, then we find vertical gap between two supply curves and this will be the total basically tax paid by the consumers and received by the income. That is the complete rectangle here. I'm labeling it again, this 72, this much, then this much, and this much, and this much. This complete box is the total amount of tax. But examiner is saying that what would be the amount of tax paid by the consumers. So this part is paid by the consumers because initially equilibrium price was 60, consumers were paying this much, now they will be paying this much. So tax for the consumer will be this triangle. I'm shading here now. This triangle is tax on consumer. So just find the area of this rectangle, not triangle. So height into base is the formula for rectangle. So height is 10, 60 to 70, and base is 100. So 100 into 10 is equal to 1000. Okay, so this is it for this session. I will be posting next 15 questions shortly, inshallah. Or agar aap AS exam October, November mein de rahe hain, to I suggest all of you to keep watching this video series October, November attempt. It will really help you. Aur iska jo baki ke 15 questions hai wo inshallah jaldi main unko bhi post karne ki koshish karunga. As I get some time, I will definitely do it as early as possible. So this is it. See you. Thank you.